My dear students, thank you so much for taking your valuable time in participating in this web session on design thinking. We all need to appreciate AICT for introducing this design thinking course in engineering education this year. So this makes engineering education more encouraging, experiential, and engaging. Before we go deep down into the theoretical foundation of this particular course, I'll share a small story so that you would appreciate the relevance of this particular course in engineering education, or the importance of this particular course, or why you need to really practice, why you need to really take it to the heart. So you would really, really appreciate this particular syllabus or this particular introduction at this point of time. Once there was a boy who was an aircraft cleaner. When he was cleaning the aircraft head windows, he found a manual next to that steering of that particular aircraft. It was a pictorial manual, which is a little interesting. He took that book to his hands and started opening one by one. On the top of the manual, it is written that it is a step-by-step process to fly an aircraft. It is so interesting, so exciting. So this boy took it to the heart and opened the first page. When he opened the first page, it is written that if you want to start this aircraft, press that red button next to the steering. It was so exciting to this boy. Without thinking much, he pressed that red button next to the steering. The aircraft started. Both engines were running with a very high noise. He could hear the noise of the fans which are embedded in the wings, and they are running with the high RPMs. It was so exciting. Without thinking much, he opened the next page. It is written that if you want to run the aircraft on the runway, you need to press that yellow button left side of the steering. He did not think much. With a lot of excitement, he pressed that yellow button. Aircraft started moving. It started running. It started moving with high speed. It was going on and on. It is almost reaching the dead end. And it was kind of maybe I think 500 meters or 1000 meters next to the dead end. Without thinking much, he opened the next page. Then it is written that if you have to fly the aircraft, press that blue button next to that yellow button. Without thinking much, he pressed that blue button. Immediately, aircraft started flying in the air. It was moving high. It was going high. His spirits are really high. So all his enthusiasm is unlimited, unbounded, undefined. He was going high and high. The aircraft is moving at a high speed. It was almost reaching 3000 meters above the sea level. It was going on and on. It was almost 1 hour. This boy's excitement is dwindling. He wants to come down. He wants to go back home. It was a kind of boring experience now. Then he thought, maybe if he opened the next page, it would have an instruction to how to get on, to how to land this aircraft. With that intention, he opened the next page. It was a shocking experience. Boy got panicked. It was written that if you want to land the aircraft, please refer to the volume 2 of this book. It was so distressing moment to this boy. He could not do much. There is no time. He doesn't know how to land the aircraft. It was running, running, running. Fuel got exhausted completely. After some time, this got landed in the sea and it got crashed. My dear students, probably you must be thinking, why I'm actually talking about this particular story at this point of time? What is the connection between this and this particular course? Believe me or not, when we were all kids, probably when we were studying third class or fourth class or fifth class, We were all creative. We are all innovative, right? So we were doing a lot of experiments. Our thinking is unbounded completely. However, there were kind of restrictions imposed by the family members and the society and the school and so on. When we moved to the higher education, we start learning more and more of theory, more and more of science, more and more of practice, more and more of thinking. However, we do less of practicals. When we ask for practicals, we will be told that you learn more practicals when you go for higher education, maybe at a plus two level. When we move to the plus two level, again the story repeats. You would be bound to learn more theory, more domain experience, less of practicals, and the practicals will be postponed to the higher education, probably at a UG level or PG level. We will be told that you learn more practicals when you move to the engineering or medicine. On top of this, we would add more competitiveness during this plus two time, and we kill our creativity, we kill our innovativeness, we kill our enthusiasm, we kill our natural traits, natural inquisitiveness. When we actually move to the UG level or PG level, again we will be induced with more theory, and we will postpone the practical problem to the internship or to the industry. However, when we actually get into the internship or industry level, by the time entire randomness would actually take over our philosophy, and probably if we get a good opportunity in industry, we would be successful. Else, with all the randomness, we'll be miserably failed in our education. This should not happen. This is not the right approach to the education. Looking into the serious consequence of such problems, AICT has introduced this design thinking course so that you would be practically engaged. You would be actually thinking more about the problems, more about designs, more about the solutions, more about sustainability, so that you can produce the best of the best engineering outcomes or the solutions to all the problems in the world. We all need to thank AICT for introduction of such a innovative course at this juncture, at this point of time. Thank you, AICT, for bringing this course in engineering education this year. So my dear friends, design thinking is not a tool set. It is not a technology. It is not a process, or it is not a step-by-step approach. It is a combination of all. It is a mindset. It is a process to make you more innovative. It is a process to make you creative. In the process, you would actually bring out a lot of solutions to the problems and come out the best of the best possible outcomes, which are useful to the society. This is all about design thinking. To more about the design thinking, or to bring the actual frameworks available in the design thinking, please do watch to my next video so that you would understand, you appreciate what exactly is the process and how do we actually engage in this particular process. What exactly is our involvement, and how do we really bring out the best of the design thinking? Thank you so much for patience listening. Please do watch my next video for the more updates on the design thinking. Thank you so much.